Hi there, Reverend Charles Troxell here. I come to you to talk to you about the importance of knowing what tribe you come from, of the 12 tribes of Israel. The 12 tribes of Israel is mentioned in the Holy Quran, the Torah, and the Holy Bible. And it's very important because our Heavenly Father has named the 12 gates and the entrance into heaven. And you go to Revelation chapter 21, verse 12. And many people say we're going to the pearly gates. They just don't know which gate. And had a wall great and high, and had 12 gates, and at the gates 12 angels, and the names written thereon, which are the names of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel. On the east 3 gates, on the north 3 gates, on the south 3 gates, and on the west 3 gates. And the wall of the city had 12 foundations, and in them the names of the 12 apostles of the Lamb. Now the glorious Father had man write this in a book, and it must be important. And we also know, according to Matthew, the very first chapter of Matthew, it states that Christ come from the tribe of Judah. This is his genealogy. It traces his roots all the way back to King David. And we also know that the 12 tribes of Israel is mentioned in every book of the Bible and in a lot of the books of the Torah and the Holy Quran. Now, if you go to Genesis chapter 5, and you go to verse 21 of chapter 5, and 22, and 23, and 24, it talks about Enoch, and how Enoch was really loved by God. Because verse 24, it says, and Enoch walked with God, and he was not, for God took him. Now that meant that he didn't die. All the others before Enoch died. Then if you go down to verse 29, and it shows the genealogy of Noah. And verse 29, and he called his name Noah, saying, the same shall comfort us concerning our work and toil of our hands because of the ground which the Lord hath cursed. Now Noah was loved by our divine and sacred loving Creator Father of all life. Noah was told to build the ark in order for them to cross over the flood. And with him he brought the books of his great-great-grandfather, Enoch, which Enoch wrote 366 books. They're not all in the Bible. None of them are in the Bible, but they were presented to us down through history from the time of the flood, and it was carried on. So I want you to know that the children of Israel, the 12 tribes, was mentioned in every book of the Bible. And if you go to Exodus, if you in your Bible, you go to Exodus chapter 28, verse 10. And he says, six of their names on one stone, and the other six names on the rest, on the other stone, according to their birth. Now, according to their birth, this is very important for you to know. According to their birth. So I want you to remember that. And then verse 17, and thou shalt set in the settings of stones, even four rows of stones. The first row shall be a sardis, a topaz, and a carbuncle. This shall be the first row. And the second row shall be an emerald, a sapphire, and a diamond. And the third row, a ligure, an agate, and an amethyst. And the fourth row, a beryl, an onyx, and a jasper. They shall be set in gold in their enclosing, and the stones shall be with the names of the children of Israel, 12 according to their names, like the engravings of a signet. Everyone with his name shall there be according to the 12 tribes. So Genesis and Exodus and every book of this Bible, King James Version, but it's even wrote in other books of the Amorak or Hebrew Bible that speaks the same thing. And it's very important for you to know what tribe you come from, or at least know that the conquering line of Judah is the divine and sacred Christ, Yahshua, or as the Greeks called him, Jesus Christ. But his true Hebrew name was Yahshua. But it's very important that you know these things. And I feel that the genealogy in Matthew's lets you know that he truly came from the tribe of Judah. And you have to remember according to his birth, right? So all of these books in this Bible will talk to you, was wrote according to the 12 tribes of Israel. Everything in this Bible is strongly with the 12 tribes of Israel. Now, if you can go back to Revelations, I just wanted to give you a clear sight of where it all began back in Enoch's days. Okay, now I'll go to Revelations chapter 5. And I saw in the right hand of him that sat on the throne a book written within and on the backside sealed with seven seals. And I saw a strong angel proclaiming with a loud voice, "Who is worthy to open the book and to loose the seals thereof?" And no man in heaven nor in earth, neither under the earth, was able to open the book, neither to look thereon. And I wept much, because no man was found worthy to open and to read the book, neither to look thereon. And one of the elders saith unto me, "Weep not. Behold, the line of the tribe of Judah, the root of David, hath prevailed to open the book and to loose the seven seals thereof." That's the divine Christ, our Messiah, the loving Yahshua, or as you know him as Christ Jesus, or Jesus Christ. Now, I want you to know it's very important. You can walk around the city of the glorious heavenly city all day and all night, and you won't find your way in. I don't believe so unless you know that Christ came from the tribe of Judah and you go in through his gate, or you should know your own gate and enter in. I believe the Father of creation would not make it so important that he would name the 12 gates if it meant nothing. Or I'm positive that the divine Christ did not lie to us. You know, it wasn't on earth to tell lies. And the Father of creation didn't have man write it in the book just for a big joke or a big lie. The 12 tribes of Israel and what tribe you come from is very important. And man has had many books to tell him about the 12 tribes of Israel. Now, if it's not in the Bible, then I don't believe it. Well, I got news for you. There's many things not in the Bible. The books of Enoch, the Dead Sea Scrolls, and many other books. Now, the divine and sacred comforting spirit, with the guidance of the glorious Father of creation, I was directed to write this book, Bibleskop, the 12 Pearly Gates of Heaven. This book here will tell you, according to your birth, of what tribe you come from and what tribe you should be in. And it will help you understand the 12 apostles of the Lamb and the archangels over the 12 tribes of Israel. And many things this book will tell you. This book explains some of the parts of Enoch were the 12 gates of heaven. I wish that you would know this. I pray that you know this. Not wish, I'm sorry. I pray that you know these things. And your guidance from the light within will guide you. You can purchase this book. I would love to give it to everybody all over the world free. But I can't. I don't have the finances. But you can purchase this book as an ebook on Amazon.com and Barnes & Noble/bookstore, Bibleskope, 12 Pearly Gates of Heaven, for less than $5. Now, you've been given so many books and so many wonderful people, allowed you to know so many wonderful things. It's an endless amount of people that are trying to let you know many things, and you do listen. But the stones on the 12 stones, they are healing stones and stones for guidance and stones for spiritual wisdom. It's the same as herbs in the field are for healing you. The Divine Father didn't place those stones for nothing. But no, we want to wear them as gold and silver, and here's a jasper stone, and you know, we want to be fly, or we want to look good. No, those stones were created by the Father of creation for a purpose, spiritualness, spiritual wisdom. Now, this is the book for you to learn what tribe you're from. Now, the Mormons know, they teach what tribe their people are from, but they don't teach them until they later on, until they've done so many things in order to receive their tribe they came from. But I believe that you don't need to do a lot of things. Just read. Now, don't believe me. Read your Bible. Your Bible will tell you. Read your Quran. Your Quran will tell you about the 12 tribes of Israel. The Torah will tell you about the 12 tribes of Israel and many other books. Well, I'm not saying believe me. Look it up. Do your own research. I researched the Bible for 10 years. And then I was allowed to write this book with the direction of the comforting spirit of the Father of creation. And that's what the divine Christ said. I will send unto you a new comforter, and that comforter shall be with you forever. Well, thanks and praises. God bless. Have a blessed day.